3D printing has come a long way from industrial labs to desktop convenience, and today we're checking out the Weefun TINA2S. It's compact, beginner friendly, and promises to make 3D printing simple, fun, and surprisingly frustration free. Whether you're printing toys, models, or that one part you keep losing around the house, the TINA2S claims to be your ultimate starter printer. Well, is it actually beginner gold or just a flashy box with big promises?
Buckle up, subscribe, and let's get into it.
Right out of the box, the TINA2S keeps it refreshingly simple. First up, a quick start guide that's actually useful. A big win. Then there's a starter spool of PLA filament, not a ton, but enough for a few small models, basically a test drive amount. Digging deeper, you get a bag of tools and accessories. Extra nozzle included because stuff happens. There's also an SD card preloaded with test files and Weefun's WeeBuilder slicing software, plus a USB-A adapter for the card, super clutch if your laptop ditched the SD slot. Rounding it out are a USB cable, power adapter, and the star of the show, the printer itself. The packaging deserves props. Everything is snug and secure, so no shipping disasters here. Honestly, if Amazon rated packaging, this would get 5 stars. Now let's talk about the printer. It's compact but sturdy, rocking a bright orange and white aesthetics that screams pro but also fun. It's semi-open, which keeps things approachable for adults and older kids, though you want to supervise if younger ones are around. On the top, there's a bright LCD screen paired with a simple control knob. No touchscreens here, but it's intuitive enough to make up for it. The TINA2S nails the approachable yet professional vibe. It doesn't feel like a toy, but it won't intimidate first-time users either. Solid start. Now let's see if it prints as good as it looks. Setting up this 3D printer is as simple as it gets, which is a big win for beginners. Start by removing all the protective tape. Don't miss the ones on the nozzle, lead screw, and the plastic coupling. Attention to detail here saves headaches later. Next, plug it in, attach the filament tube to the extruder, and load the spool. Here's a pro tip. Cut the filament at a sharp angle before feeding it. It makes the process smoother and avoids unnecessary jams. Once powered on, navigate the control knob to load filament. The extruder heats up to 210 Celsius in just about 3 minutes, which is fast enough to keep things moving. Feed the filament into tube and the printer takes over from there. Done and dusted. The easiest way to get started is by using the included microSD card preloaded with test models. I decided to go with the Rabbit, a 1 hour and 14 minute print. Insert the card, select the model, and the printer auto-homes the bed and the extruder. No manual adjustments required. Before the print starts, you might notice a bit of filament oozing out of the nozzle. Don't panic, just carefully remove it, and yes, it's hot, so be cautious. The printing process kicks off with a smooth and satisfying first layer, or raft if you prefer, which is key to a successful print. Watching the rabbits take shape layer by layer is oddly mesmerizing, and it's a great confidence booster, especially if you're new to 3D printing. It makes you feel like a tech wizard, even if it's just a tiny rabbit. The starter filament is wide PLA, perfect for beginners. It doesn't need extreme temperatures and there's enough for a few prints. While Weefun recommends using their filament, any standard PLA should work fine. Just avoid experimenting with tricky materials like PETG. This is not the printer for these materials. Stick to the basics and you're good. And there you have it, setup done, rabbit printing, and your 3D printing journey officially underway. One of the best features here is the auto bed leveling. The sensor next to the extruder handles all the adjustments, saving you the headache of manual leveling. For beginners or those who just want a hassle-free setup, this is a huge plus. The magnetic bed is not heated, which limits material options, but for PLA it works perfectly. The bed slides forward easily, making model removal simple. The prints? Clean, detailed and surprisingly accurate for such a compact printer. The built-in Wi-Fi is another standout. With the PolarPrint Cloud app, you can send models directly to the printer, no need to mess with SD cards. I tested it with a different model and it's transferred flawlessly. This is great for quick changes or when you want to print something on the fly. Turning a simple idea into a 3D printed model is easier than you would expect. Start by creating or downloading a 3D design and saving it as an STL file. If you're new to this, free online tools make converting 2D designs into 3D models a breeze. WeBuilder, the included slicing software, is refreshingly straightforward. Load your STL file, adjust the scale if needed, and let the app handle the slicing for you. For beginners, the preloaded TINA2S profile is a lifesaver. Just stick to the recommended auto settings for material, PLA in this case. Advanced users can tweak options like print speed or infill density, but honestly, the default works surprisingly well. One neat feature: WeBuilder automatically adds a raft to improve bed adhesion, so you don't need to worry about prints detaching mid-process. Once slicing is done, the software generates the G-code and you're ready to go. G-code might sound intimidating, but WeBuilder simplifies it. Think of G-code as a script that directs the printer, move here, extrude there, etc, etc. The app and included USB cable make setup flexible. Use Wi-Fi, print directly from your computer, or stick with an SD card if you're old school like me. There are plenty of websites offering free or paid 3D models. Once downloaded, load them into WeBuilder, adjust the size, slice it, and you're ready to go. At work, I use a large 3D printer, but at home, the TINA2S handles quick, small projects with ease. For around $200 US, its print quality is impressive. It works best with PLA, great for entry-level materials, but lacks a heated bed for ABS or other high-temperature plastics. The compact build volume is ideal for small parts or beginner projects, but it's not designed for large-scale prints. Noise levels are noticeable but not excessive. Silent stepper drivers would make it more suitable for shared spaces. If you're looking for an entry-level 3D printer that's compact, affordable, and beginner-friendly, the Weefun TINA2S is an excellent choice. Its auto-bed leveling, Wi-Fi connectivity, and compatibility with open-source software make it approachable for newcomers. For simple projects or small parts, it delivers solid results.
Thanks for sticking around. I'll see you in the next one. Mm-hmm.